I know.
Ow.
I know, honey. I'm all set. Just gotta find my glasses.
Now, what can I do?
You're wearing them.
Nothing. I'm just all... I am? Oh, okay. All right, then I'm all set.
You couldn't organize a two-car funeral.
Gloria, it was funny.
All right, let's go.
All right.
You know what you need to do?
Oh, a lesson. This is exciting. Gloria, listen, because you might learn something.
Listen, this is very important. You make a list of all the things you have to do.
Okay, a list.
This way you won't be so panicked all the time.
You're the one panicking, honey.
Look, you two, go to the car. You can argue there.
Good idea. You all set?
Yes, I'm all set. Just go put your coat on and go outside and warm up the car.
Why don't you walk out with me? Unless you lost something again.
No, I didn't, Perry Mason. I just want to go kiss the baby.
You were just up there.
I'm going to be gone all day, all right? I'm a mother. Can I love my child?
Okay, I'm sorry.
Okay.
Fine.
Yeah, marry somebody else who doesn't love the kids like I do and see what your life is like.
You know, it's amazing.
I am amazing.
It doesn't
Thank
matter
you,
how
sweetheart.
Early you get started.
Uh-huh.
You still find 17 things to do just before we walk out the door.
17?
17. I counted them.
It's an interesting number.
Yeah.
Yeah, go wait.
Bye, dear.
Bye, dear.
Gloria.
What?
I did lose something else.
What?
My cell phone.
Oh, don't worry about it now. You'll have a fit, honey.
No, I gotta have it. What if one of the kids gets sick or needs me? Come on, help me find it. Don't say anything to him.
Okay. I'll call it. We'll hear it ring.
Perfect. All right. Tell me when it's ringing.
Okay. It's ringing. Oh, wait, it's coming from over here.
Okay.
Hello.
It's Mark. Hola, ¿dónde está tu amiga? Ay, caramba, cuando rego me encuentro no encuentro nada. Mamá, tío Luisa, ¿cómo gritas si yo no estamos todas? Ahí, la cocina, amigas, tacos.
I'll be in the car.
Think he knows it was me?
Yeah, I don't think he fooled him.
No, just Gloria and Mark are sick, and the kids are fine, and I'm fine, and... Yes, I'm giving him tea. Right, you know what? I'm so late. The kids have already missed the bus. Can I just call you after the show? Yeah. Today? The psychic guy, Kevin Powalski. Yeah, the guy who talks to the dead, right?
Oh, I love him.
Okay. No, that's Gloria. Gloria, my mom says hi.
Hi.
Hi. Okay, Mom, I'll call you back later. Okay. Oh. Gloria, my mom says bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Okay, Mom. I love you too. Okay, bye.
Oh, your ride's here.
Oh, thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Any coffee?
Oh, yeah, real pod, but we're all drinking tea.
Barb, I'm so late. The kids missed the bus. Could you drive them to school and I'll just take a cab in?
I am at your service.
Okay. Bonnie, go get ready.
Going hot, hot, hot.
Ooh, coconut cake.
Marv, do you always wear shorts?
Yes, I do, but these are lined.
Oh.
Is killing me.
Okay, honey. Here's your tea. Hot, hot, hot. Some cough drops, cherry, okay?
Let me breathe.
All right, I'll put some mentholatum on your chest.
Honey, you're gonna be late. You should go. Are the kids ready?
No, Gloria's sick, too. She was up all night.
Yeah, but I'm really sick.
Okay, and I'm really late.
Did you make any breakfast?
Starve a cold.
Feed a cold. Starve a fever.
Okay, well, let's get rid of your fever first, okay? Here we go.
Man, I can't even smell the mentholatum.
You will. Just give it a second.
I can't shake this thing. I feel like I was hit by a truck.
All right, honey. It's going around. You'll be fine.
That feels better.
See? All set then, okay? All right, honey.
Man, am I sick.
I know, honey.
Honey, your blouse is buttoned wrong.
What else is new? Okay. I gotta make lunches, get the kids out the door, feed the baby, get Gloria some tea.
I'm really sick.
I know, honey.
I mean, really, really sick.
I know. You have a cold and a fever.
I know, and I'm sick.
Well, I'm going to come home right after work.
You come right home, right? Because
yes.
I'm sick.
Yes, I'm going to come right home. Okay, just rest and get some sleep. I love you.
I love you. I'm sick.
I know. Samantha, honey, come on, let's go.
Almost ready.
Charlie, what are you doing?
I'm coming.
Okay, honey, Mommy's late. What are you doing in your baseball uniform?
Well, you told me to get dressed. This is the only clean thing I have.
Okay, well, where are your white shirts and your school pants?
In the hamper.
Dig them out. You can still wear them, honey. Come on, I'm so late.
Oh, brother.
Yeah, oh, brother.
Ready?
Okay, honey.
You just have to comb my hair. I tried, but it's too painful.
Oh, dear. Maybe it's a good day to finally cut it.
Mom.
All right, just get a bandana and meet me downstairs. I gotta change Connor.
Oh, I wish I could get her to ask Psychic Powalski about my dear Aunt Sylvia.
Have I met her?
Oh, no. No, she's the one who just recently...
Oh, I'm sorry.
I forgot he also spoke to the dead.
Oh, it's okay. It was recent, and she was heavy, and...
Heart attack?
No. No, she was suffocated by a large coconut while vacationing in Hawaii.
Really?
Oh, my uncle's last words to her were, "Honey, I'll bet your head could fit in here." It's sad, isn't it? You know, he lives with the guilt every day, yet I've told him over and over again it's not his fault.
Of course not.
After all, she wasn't killed by the coconut.
No.
It was the islanders banging her head against a palm tree trying to free her. Oh, God rest her soul.
Amen.
Okay. Mark's gonna drive you to school, honey.
Okay.
Bonnie, I'm gonna go out and warm up the car.
What, honey?
Can you get my bandana?
All right.
You know, I think Marvel asked Psychic Powalski about my dear Aunt Sylvia.
Does she want to know her future?
Oh, she doesn't have one, honey.
Gloria's aunt is in heaven.
And you know someone that can talk to her?
Yes.
No. Well, anybody can talk to someone in heaven, honey. You just pray and they're listening. They just don't talk back.
Well, then how do you know they're listening or answering?
Well, you ask Kevin Powalski. He is amazing. One time, he told this Italian woman that her father loved noodles. She started sobbing right there on the spot. She said her dad ate pasta all the time.
Don't most Italians eat pasta?
You know, I think my fever's coming back. Oh, I'm gonna go rest on the sofa.
Samantha, I'm gonna give Daddy a bottle for Connor. Will you make the lunches for me?
Yeah, can I make whatever I want?
Whatever you want.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Cake. And, cookies. Oh, boy. Cookies, cookies, cookies. Candy. Ooh, candy.
Gotta have that.
Ooh, an apple.
Good girl. What do you need, McKees?
Sorry I'm late, but my dad and me went to the guys in the Cadillac watch in our house to avoid.
What do you want for lunch, Frankie?
I'll take the usual.
Okay.
I'm making the lunches today, Frankie.
Love that.
Charlie, come on, sweetheart. Marv's waiting in the car. Okay, let me get his coat.
Excuse me. Okay, I'm all set.
Okay, honey, you know what? I don't want you to get Daddy's cold, so you just leave your coat on all day. Do you hear me?
Yep.
All right.
Thank you.
Zip it up. There you go. Great day.
Are you trying to kill me?
Sorry. The baby spit up at me. I had a change, and both Gloria and Mark are sick, Bagel.
Doctors don't get sick.
Yeah, they do. Moms don't.
Anyway, today's guest is psychic/medium Kevin Powalski.
Yes, I know.
Well, he's here to promote his new book on tape,
Dead Man Talking.
Did you listen to it?
I tried to in the car, but it scared the kids. What is so funny? He does dead people's voices, and it's not funny, David. It's scary for kids.
Well, you know what, Bonnie? Some people find it very comforting to know their future or to hear it from their dead and stinking relatives.
Well, if they want a sign from their relatives, why don't they just look for, like, a leaf falling on a table when they're in an outdoor cafe? They don't need a third party for their dead relatives to speak to them. You think God didn't figure that out? You thought it was going to be a business or something where you had to hire somebody to talk to the people that are up in heaven with him? That's ridiculous. He's God. He made the world.
Could you please use punctuation when you talk, just once?
Did you even hear what I said?
Well, there were no periods, there were no pauses.
All right, well, you got me all riled up.
I'm sorry. Now look, Mr.
Yelling at me the minute I come in.
Let's listen with our eyes, please. Mr. Powalski also wants to do a recipe for hamburgers, so you can do your interview from the cooking corner.
He's doing a cooking segment?
What is so funny about that? This is about his whole thing.
We're talking about a psychic. You're telling me he's going to do a recipe for hamburgers.
Well, this is a part of his act. You know, he has his
act.
Own... Well, promotion. He has his own show on the Psychic Food Network. Very, very hot.
I didn't even know there was a Psychic Food Network. When will it end?
Can't you just interview people without asking questions?
Oh, that makes a lot of sense. You don't even know what you said, Mr. Punctuation.
Well.
Is he here yet?
Who?
The psychic guy, Kevin Powalski.
Not yet.
You okay, Tony?
He scares me. He gives me the heebie-jeebies.
Morning.
You scared me.
No, you're not so pretty yourself first thing in the morning.
Oh, my gosh. Everything go okay with the kids?
Hey, okay.
Great. Thank you, Marv. I really appreciate it.
Morning.
Hey, Hal. Mm-hmm.
What's wrong?
Breathe.
Just breathe, Tony. Relax. Everything's fine. I wouldn't suggest that you eat when you're so scared, because I don't want you to
okay?
Okay.
I am so excited.
About what?
I hope the psychic says I'm going to get married again.
I can tell you that.
This walking in at the last minute has got to stop. Okay, meeting! Bunch up!
Right here.
Whatever. Listen up, people. Now, we can't keep coming in here late day after day. And I blame you, Bonnie, for this behavior.
Me?
You did it.
Ring leader. You know why? Because Ms. Malloy, you have late disease.
Oh, I got it.
And you're spreading it to everyone here on this show.
I got it from her.
Well, from now on, you can thank Bonnie for making you show up 45 minutes before the show. Or I will be forced to call Mr. Portenbody and look into having each and every one of you replaced.
That's good.
Get it? Got it good.
Oh, scary.
David.
Uh-oh, there he goes.
David.